Hey folks, Greg here, and today we're going to do something just a little bit different. About a year and a half ago, I switched from backpacking with a tent to backpacking with a hammock, and I also started making a lot of my own gear. Over that year and a half, almost 2 years now, I've actually built several different hammocks. It turns out that I have three hammocks of three different lengths, and one of the questions that came up on hammockforums.net is how does the length of a hammock affect how comfortable it is? How long should I make my hammock? How big should I make it? Well, I happen to have a 9.5 foot long hammock, a 10.5 foot long hammock, and a 12.5 foot long hammock. So we're gonna go set all three of them up and see what makes them different. Let's go find out, because I haven't done this before, so I don't know what's gonna happen. All right, let's go see. Okay, well, this is hammock number one, the first one I built. And the material length on this is 9.5 feet long. The ridge line is 96 inches. I backpacked most of two summers ago using just this hammock, and I love it. It was comfortable enough. It was certainly much more comfortable than a tent, but now that I've been backpacking with hammocks for about a year and a half, almost 2 years, I've noticed some things. First of all, what I thought was a diagonal lay was not much of a diagonal lay. I definitely feel kind of a hyperextension of my knee. If I try to go diagonally, it's actually quite difficult to do. The shortness of this hammock is sort of wanting to pull me back into the center line. I'm just feeling a lot of pressure here on my head coming back in this way. My feet are feeling a lot of pressure going back up to the end that way. So while going diagonally like this certainly does help, I still feel some hyperextension of this knee. I've got a big ridge line right under my knee. My head is fine. I always use a little roll of a jacket or something behind my neck. But yeah, I'm noticing now what I remember from backpacking over a year ago, that it was comfortable, but not as comfortable as it could be. Now, look at this. Even when I try to go diagonally, the ridge line is probably just above my shoulder here, and I'm probably an equal amount over on my feet from this side. It's not a huge amount of diagonal angle on this. So let's compare this to a hammock which is only 1 foot longer and has a 10-inch longer ridge line, so it'll have a little more sag. And let's see how that looks. All right. Okay, let's see if we can get this done before the rain comes in. The wind's starting to come up, starting to get a little stormy. This is the second hammock. This one is 10.5 feet long, 106-inch ridge line. So the ridge line is 10 inches longer, the fabric is 12 inches longer, which should give me a little bit more sag. In fact, it's noticeably more sag. This is not in my face at all. I could also get much more of a diagonal lay in this. I'm still feeling some pressure at my head. I'm really not feeling the pressure at my feet, and I'm not feeling that hyperextended knee anymore. In fact, the knee ridge that people talk about with hammocks is, in this case, directly below my knee. There we go. Yeah, I can definitely get more of a diagonal lay. Not as much as I've seen some other people get with their hammocks, but it's still quite comfortable. In fact, vastly more comfortable than the 9.5 foot. So 1 foot of extra length, 10 inches of extra ridgeline has made quite a difference. This is very comfortable. Like I said, a whole year of backpacking with this. This feels like home. This is what I'm used to. But the next hammock is even longer. So let's see what difference that makes. All right, so here's the new hammock. This is the big rig. 12.5 feet long material length, 116 inches. On the ridgeline, so that's considerably more sag. Notice it's only an additional 10 inches of ridgeline from the last hammock, but 2 feet of extra cloth from the last hammock. Once again, the extra length in the cloth makes it vastly less restricting this way. Now I have an excellent diagonal lay. I don't have the hyperextension of the knee problem at all. In fact, my knees are actually bent a little bit the other way. The ridgeline, not ridgeline this, but the knee ridge that is so typical of hammocks does exist, but it's essentially non-existent for the way I'm laying in it here. I'm feeling a little bit of tightness right under my thighs, my knee, but nothing like the other ones at all. It's essentially not there. Notice how much more diagonal I could sleep in this. Also notice that the ridge line is not in my face. It's a full arm's length away. This is nice. This is incredibly comfortable. I'm really looking forward to using this, you know, all this year. So there you go. The difference in length absolutely does make a difference in how constricted you are width-wise and how easy it is to get a diagonal lay. By the way, I actually have a little bit of slack here. I'm not feeling that pressure on my head at all, and I have a little bit of slack at my feet. So both those pressure points are completely gone to the point where I actually have a little extra material. The last thing we should look at is, with a hammock this long, how does my underquilt fit? How do you get an underquilt to wrap around something when you're laying this diagonally? Does that work? We got the camera out. Let's find out. The answer is yes. The quilt does fit on a long hammock like this. So I can wrap it up even above my head, although I usually wear a down hood. Thunder's walking around here. He wants to be part of the video. My feet extend just a little bit beyond the edge of the quilt, and I could put the shock line over the top of my feet, which is what Shug suggests in his hammock newbie videos. I'm definitely not noticing any sort of restriction from the quilt. Well, let's add in the top quilt, see how it works with all that hammock length. There we go. That shock cord goes over the top of my foot. Oh, I've got plenty of insulation around my shoulder. Wow, lots of room. Yeah, I can completely snuggle inside this entirely. This is great. And by the way, I'm 6'1", so you know, if you're shorter than I am, this would be even more comfortable. Again, I'm not feeling any pressure on my head. I'm not feeling any hyperextension of my knees. It's just incredibly comfortable and really, really warm, because this is my 15 to 20 degree quilt and I'm already starting to burn up in here. I want to show you guys one more thing. Frankie showed me something about bottom quilts. That when we went backpacking a few months ago, it got into the mid-20s. Not super cold, but you know, below freezing. And I was having a bit of a cold butt. And the next morning I mentioned that to him, and he checked out how I had my underquilt set up. And we found something that really helped me a lot. So I'm gonna change camera angle and show you what I learned. All right. Boy, I just wanna stay here, it's so comfy. Hey folks, this last little tip is something I learned from Frankie. And when we went on our trip, I found that even though it was only in the mid-20s, not super cold by any means, I still had a bit of a cold butt syndrome going on. I was getting air underneath the underquilt somehow. And I asked him to look at my setup the next morning, and he noticed this. When I built this, I have this shock cord in here, which my idea was that it would always pull up tight against the hammock and would not leave an air gap. I even have a baffle right here full of down that would fill up any gaps. It turns out that when it's too tight, I don't know if I can make this happen without me actually lying in it, but that gap wound up causing, somehow in the way I was hanging on it, causing a hole here. The solution was simply to loosen it a little bit, and now the hammock was able to sort of more form to the shape, to the curve. When it was too tight, something was going on. I think it might have been actually sitting kind of like that, you know, across a tight hammock here. I think it may have been doing something like that, you know, of causing a little U-shape hang like that. Whereas when it's a little looser, it has the real estate to move and fill up. And so that just seemed to help a lot. I have not had a cold butt since I've tried extending this a little bit. So that's the last tip. I hope that information was helpful to you. I certainly learned a lot making 3 hammocks over the last year and a half to 2 years. And let's get out there and keep hanging. All right, take care.